I've lost 180 pounds with a combination of carnivore, keto, and counting calories. I reached my goal in November of 2022, and over the past year and a half, I've noticed the scale went up about 8 pounds. Let's experiment with carnivore and counting calories and see what improvements I can make. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Welcome to my chaos, but I went to Walmart this week and I picked up 6 different meats. They're all 1 pound. So please note, before this even starts, this experimenting, I'm using 1 pound packages. And as you know, meat is usually cheaper if you buy the big logs or family packs, but I didn't need that much. I just wanted to do it with 1 pound of each, so everything could be standard. I need to make this a standardized experiment. So I've got all 6 crock pots back there, and we're going to start off with putting the ground beef in each crock pot. So oftentimes I put, when I cook my meat, I'm cooking it in crock pots, and then I use it in whatever way I want to use it, especially when I'm keto. Right now that I'm carnivore, I'm not doing that, but right now I'm just doing the burgers. But what I'm trying to see is which meat you're going to get the most meat after it's cooked, and then compare that to the dollar amount for how much we paid for it. So let me go grab my trash can. I'll be right back. Okay, people ask me all the time, why don't you use chicken, or why don't you use this? And I like the taste of chicken. But the drawback, so that was chicken. This is 80% ground beef. That's going to go back here. I have little Post-its in front of them so I can keep them straight. But my biggest beef, with chicken is that after it's cooked, you only get like about half of how much you started with. And that really disturbs me mentally. This is 96%. So in the past, long time ago, I did an experiment, but it wasn't with this many, and I didn't label it in a good enough way that I can go back and refer to it. So we're going to recreate that experiment, and so that'll be good. So that's 96%. Let me find my 93%. Now let me get these little things on here. So, like I said, whenever I'm keto, or even when I was carnivore, I sometimes just get tired of burgers and I want a different texture, so I go to ground meat. And so, when I'm doing ground meat, like I said, I do it in the crock pot. You guys have seen me do that so many times. So, and I do use liners. These are the Reynolds Kitchen slow cook liners. So I got to have my plastic, baby. This is 73%. Because I am not washing all 6 of these crock pots. And after I get all of these in here, then I add water. But just for remembering what was where, I needed to do it this way. So this one is 85%. You know, the burgers that I make, those are 85%. I've never really bought 85% ground beef to use. But like I said, so many of these burgers don't come, or these percentages, they don't come in big things. You know what I mean? You can only buy them in like individual 1 pounders. So I just want to do this experiment to see if it's even worth my time. Now from here, I'm going to add 1 cup of water. So I got my water and I'll fill it up, and I want to make sure I want them all to be the same, so that way they're not, you know, we want it to be a nice controlled study group. All right, so 1 cup of water, I'm going to add a cup of water, and after I add it, I'll turn them all, each one on, that way we're, okay, so I'm putting this one on low, but I add the water. Because from here, sometimes the more leaner things, they stick to the side of the container or plastic, whichever way I do it. And The water just kind of helps with that. So now, don't get me wrong, the chicken adds plenty of water. Can you tell I'm salty about the chicken part? But anyway, so that was, oh, wait, y'all saw it. I forgot to turn on low. All right, that one's on low. Okay, now it's 96. This one's the 93%. This is the pitcher I used to fill the dog's water bowls. So this one's 93%. And like I said, the leaner the meat, I definitely have to add water. Like the 73%, and I don't have to add water, but like I said, just to make it an evenly controlled experiment, I want to add the water. So let's go over here to the chicken. Don't want to set it up to fail even before I start. Alright, so let's put that one on low. Can you tell? I mean, if you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Terry. I am a hoarder. Hoarder of lots of different things. I'm a hoarder of crock pots is one of the things I hoard. That's alright. You know what? If there's a crock pot shortage, I will have me a crock pot. Okay, that's on low. These big ones are going to probably get done faster, but that's not the part I'm trying to keep tabs on. It's just a matter of how much meat we're left over with, how much usable meat we have, and because I don't really care about how much broth we have. Now, you'll see I'm not seasoning any of it because at the end, I want to be able to use the broth and the fat in whatever way I want to. You know, you can keep this rendered fat when you're done and use it to cook with. So if I don't season it, then everything is just going to be all clean. So, or you can use it for your dogs. I'm double checking. Low. You can give it to your dogs. You can do like I do and water the grass with it because I have so much of it. And then I wonder if my lawn guys wonder why there's like these patches of like ruined grass. It's all right. So anyway, so now from this stage, I let them cook and I say, hey, Ziggy, set a crock pot timer for 1 hour.
Crock pot timer, 1 hour, starting now.
And I'll show you what I do. And I set a paper plate and a little chopper jobber. And every hour, we're going to come in and break them up. You want to use it as one big loaf, that's cool. I don't, because I like that texture. So anyway, so all right, I will see you in 1 hour, and we'll see how it goes down. I'm going to hold you, and then I'll let you, I'll show all of them. But this one is the 96%. So you see, I come in every hour. And I just chop it up. And that's all I do. I just chop it up. Just gently so I don't tear the plastic because I've done that before. But I chop it up because, like I said, I don't want one big loaf. And so I'll do this. Like I said, I'm not trying to destroy it. That's the 96. This one is the 93. Gently, kind of. Again, the leaner it is, the stiffer it is, because it doesn't have that rendered fat that's kind of helping it break apart. So, the leaner it is, the drier it's going to be, and the clumpier it's going to be. I have to work harder on the leaner stuff. But again, this is the 96%. Back here, we got the 80%. Don't be getting dizzy on me, y'all. Don't be getting dizzy. Let me put this lid back on here. Alrighty. So back here is the 80%. It's easier to chop up this little thing in this big one. But you see, we just want it to be one, or we don't want it to be one big clump. We want it to be loose. All right, let's jump over to here to this one, which is the, I think it's 85%. Oh, tear. Hang on, I got a little issue going on here. Pull my plastic up here and hang on. I should have walked around, but sometimes I don't think with my brain. Sometimes I think with my, I don't know, I guess I think with my butt. But this one's 85%. And I come in and do this every hour. Let's walk around. Hang on. There we go. All right. So see, we want it to be kind of like Taco Bell meat. I can take this lid off. And then I'll set that in here. And while that's sitting in there, let's get our lid and put it back on there. Sorry if you're getting seasick. This one is 73%. And then the last one's going to be chicken. Now, I probably shouldn't use this same chopper for the chicken. Let me see if I have something else that I can use for the chicken. Hang on just a second. We're going to use Mama's whooping spoon. This was our Kool-Aid spoon growing up, but it also worked. It also had a second job. If Terry was acting bad, this would work as a whooping spoon. Not that Terry was a bad child. She was a very innocent, well-behaved child, I'm here to tell you. So she never got a whooping. All right. So there. So we got that one. And we'll just set them both here. And I just leave these spoons out. And again, I say, hey, Ziggy. Crockpot timer. For 1 hour.
Timer. 1 hour. Starting now.
Okay. So I got my crockpot timer 1 hour. And there it all is. And so there they're going. And we'll be back in an hour. Okay, so now we come in for round two, and we go through and just gently break it up. Again, the thicker or the leaner stuff is going to be a little more harder to chop because there's just less fat to chop through it. It's easier not having you guys in my hands, no offense, but... Still, you just come through and break it up every hour. Now, I fully understand you could stand over a hot skillet and do this. But when I'm doing this, I'm usually doing the big 10-pounders. So I need something that is going to be, I need a way that I can do, I can mass produce it. And I'm sorry, but I'm not going to stand over a skillet and cook 10 pounds of ground beef in 3 or 4 batches. When all I got to do is come in and do this every hour. And then from there, I can, for that hour, I get to go play video games or text my mama or do whatever it is I want to do. So it is not that time consuming normally. I don't have 6 crock pots going. But anyway, so typically I have the 2 big crock pots going whenever I'm doing them. Whenever I put 5 pounds in, usually I buy the 10 pounder and I'll put 5 pounds in one and 5 pounds in the other. During COVID, meat was not easy to get all the time. So I went to a local, oh my goodness. Well, slaughterhouse, but I can't think of the proper term for it. Anyway, a plant, you know, a processing plant. We had a meat processing plant, and I would go there, and I could buy 1 pound packages, and I would buy a certain amount every payday. I think I used to get 22. I don't remember. But anyway, so now, you know, I've chopped through all of it. And the back ones are getting done faster, the bigger ones. But that's because they're more powerful. And so they will probably be done after this next hour. And the smaller ones, they're older. They just don't have quite as much power. So these two will probably take another 2 hours. Those will probably take another 1 hour. This one, these might only take 1 hour also. Well, these three will probably take another hour. And this is chicken, so I want to really make sure this gets done. So these will probably finish up in an hour, and these will probably finish up in 2 hours. But either way, I'm going to set my timer for 1 hour. And when it's done, I'll show you how I like it to look, so the beef, so that way I know it's done. Okay, I've already done one. I'm going to do another one. This is the 80%. It was in my big crock pot. And so what I did was I got the meat and I separated the liquid. And I'm going to have this set aside. I'm doing another one. This is the 85%. I just poured it into my colander. And now we're going to put the beef into here. Stick that in there for a minute. And then I'm going to pour the liquid into this. Get that wiped off. And so the way I know that my ground beef is done, there's a little pink to it, just a teeny tiny little bit of pink, but the majority of it is brown. So this is more like medium steak, you know, little pink, but not a lot. So I'm gonna set this aside and I'm gonna see if any of the others are ready to go. So I'm gonna give you a bird's eye view of the meat. See how it's just a little tiny bit pink? See if I can get you in there better. It's just a little pink. That's how I know, for my opinion, that it's done. It's just a little pink, but there is still, it's still together. It's still that texture of ground beef. So now, hang on just a second here. What I really want you to see is how I deal with the plastic. I pull it out, I slosh it around here. Get all the meat. This is the 73%. I work to get all the meat in one corner. And then I just kind of drop it in. And just pour it out into the colander. So I'm getting out as much meat as possible. Make sure you're wearing old clothes, because that grease will definitely stain your clothes. So, and you can see here by the looks of this one, it doesn't keep it perfectly clean, but you know, it works for me. I like it. So now, again, I'm gonna put my little 73% sticker on here so I can figure out which one it is. And I will dump it into here. Again, we're just trying to see which one we cook and get the most meat out of, so we can figure out the most bang for our buck. So I'll set you in there. And there's definitely more liquid in this one. So we'll pour it in there. All right. So I'm going to check the other two. There's two more of the smaller ones. I don't know exactly where they are in their stage of cooking. So either way, whatever I do, I'll come back to you when those are all done, when the chicken and the other two are done, and then we'll kind of start looking at things. We know the backs of my counters are full, so it's just gonna look cluttered, but I live here and I'm not perfect, so we ain't worrying about that. So we're gonna weigh it, starting off in... Y'all, this is editing Terry here. When I made this, I was trying to weigh grams and ounces, and it was just a big mess. So I'm just going to cut in here and tell you about it. Now I have a 73 ounces, or 73% ground beef, and that ended up weighing 9.6 cooked ounces. Then my 80%, it was 9.6 cooked ounces. The cooked chicken, after it was cooked, it was 10.9 ounces. The 85% was 11.2 ounces. The 93% was 11.3 ounces. And 96 was 11.4 ounces. So that's the ounces that I got. And I'm going to cut out all this little piddling around I'm doing because I jibber-jabber too much. So I'm going to cut all this out and go to the math portion. From here, it's going to take some serious math. So we've got these figured out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to portion these out in Ziploc bags. So that way future Terry will know what she's getting and how much it is. So I'm going to get these portioned out. I'm just going to put the whole thing in one bag, and later on Terry can just use it how she wants to. So after I get this done, I'll be back. So from here, I've got them all broken down into portions. Meal prep day or eating day, Terry's going to be able to see that says 96%. I got my 93, my 85, my chicken, my 80, and my 73. I'm going to set these in the freezer like this to freeze, and I will be back. Sorry, I forgot to say, I usually set them on a cookie sheet, so that way they're all pretty flat. So this is how they're going to freeze, like this. From here, I'm going to take my chicken broth, and I'm just going to put it in here. And last time I did it, it kind of congealed, and I just gave the dog bites of chicken for treats. So, I had little bites, but anyway, So I'll share that with the dogs. And then I'm going to rinse this out. Give me just a second. From here, I'm going to put all the beef broth in here. And what I'm going to do with that is I am going to let this harden, and I'll skim the fat off the top, and I'll use that, and we'll make dog treats out of that. If you go back to any of my old videos where I do a crock pot, a bunch of ground beef, you can see how I turn them into dog treats. I'm not sure I'll have enough time. If I do, enough time to record it on this video. Sometimes it only lets me upload so much at a time, but I'll show you if I can. I just may not show you the whole process. But first I have to let this separate, and I have to see how much it even is. If it's not much, then I won't do it. But if you already have broth and you got too much, I just toss it half the time. But I'm going to try. We'll see. It doesn't look like, it only looks like the fat cap's going to be that tall. So I don't think I'm going to do anything with this, to be quite honest. So actually, yeah. That will be the end of the broth that you're going to see. The dogs will get this. This, like I said, you can save this broth and use it later. I have a freezer full of broth, so I'm not going to. I'm just going to toss this out in the yard. But I will hang on to the chicken, because that congeals, and this does not. So this just becomes I could try it. I'll see if it congeals. Anyway, that's the end of the broth.
Okay, guys, I apologize for the horrible handwriting, but I just want to go over this with you. So what I did was I have the meat percentage and the dollar per pound raw, how much it cost, dollars per ounce raw, then the cooked weight and the cooked dollar per ounce. So this is based off the 1 pound packages. As you know, you can buy 73% in 10 pounds, and that's $3.47 instead of $5.34. You can buy the 80% in a 5 pound package, and it's $4.63 instead of $5.93. But up here we're comparing apples to apples, and then we'll go apples to oranges. So it's 73% buying just the 1 pound package. The cooked weight was 9.6 ounces, which ends up being 56 cents per ounce. 80% got 9.6 ounces, which is 62 cents per ounce. Chicken got us 10.9 ounces, which was 29 cents per ounce. 85% was 57 cents, because it was 11.2, and it was 57 cents per ounce. The 93 and 96, these are pretty similar, so I would not buy the 96 at all. But the 93%, it came out to 11.3, and that was 11.4, and 69 cents and 70 cents. So let's compare apples to apples. Of course, the cheapest is going to be the chicken. So I stand corrected. Even with all the amount that I lose in the chicken, that is the cheapest. Next cheapest is going to be the 73%. So that's number two. And then the next is 85%. So that's three. And then next you have your 80%, which will be four. And then five and six. So, but then let's come down and compare. You know, chicken, you can't get ground chicken in a bigger package, I don't think. Now I will look, but I always see my Walmart's the 1 pound. So it's 29 cents per cooked ounce of chicken. Then you come down here, and if you get the 10 pound, I call it a chub, of the 73%, it's 36 cents per cooked ounce. Then the 80% is 48 cents per cooked ounce. So that 48%, it's not quite twice as much. But we're still, just so you know, if you buy the 10 pounds of the 73%, it is 36. So you got 29 cents an ounce of chicken, 36 cents per ounce of 73%. So there is 7 cents difference between chicken and then the 73. So I'm going to put that down right here. Hang on. Dang it. 7 cents between this and the chicken. That's supposed to be a little cent sign. It's hard to do this through the screen. So 48 minus 29. Ziggy, 48 minus 29.
48 minus 29 is
19. All right, so 19 cents difference. So you got to decide what's best. So if you like chicken, then that's the cheapest. Then if you want beef, which I like beef more than chicken, I just stay full longer and I feel better. You can buy the 73%. Rinse off the fat, and you're going to get 36 cents per ounce. And so, anyway, or you can get the 80% and it'll be 48 cents per ounce. So I just wanted to show you. So I stand corrected. The last time I did this, I thought 80% was the best option, but it's been a while, and maybe that was probably about 3-4 years ago. So maybe things have changed. But I just want you to see that, so dollar per dollar, the chicken is the cheapest. The next cheapest would be a 10-pound pack of 73% ground beef, and then a 5-pound pack of 80%. So that's the options, and I just wanted to show you all what you get. So now we know. So, all right, so even buying the big old 73% and losing what you lose, you're still gonna be better off than getting the leaner meat. So there we go. Now we know. So I want you to see that layer of fat. It's just a teeny tiny layer of fat. That's not gonna be anything that I can do anything for the dogs. So if you wanted to, you could skim that off. That's because there's so much lean meat. When I do the 73%, there's a lot of the fat caps, usually like from there to there, but it's just that little bitty thing. There's nothing I'm gonna be able to do with that. So at this stage, you know, I could make broth and pour it into jars or into a flat Ziploc bag or whatever, but I just wanted you all to see that's how thin the fat cap is. So I'm not gonna be able to make treats out of that. I
you know, that's not going to do anything for the dog. So I just wanted to show you that. But all right, that is the end. Bye.
Hey, really quick. Meanwhile, this is the chicken. I did stir it up. But see how that's a little more gelatinous? This will harden up, and I will be able to give the dogs a spoonful of this. So that's, I'll just give them a treat every now and then. A little bite of gelatin. Chicken, it'll be like chicken bites. So that's what I plan to do with the chicken. So now you're officially in the loop. Okay, now I'm done. Bye.